Thing, but is it more documentary or more eulogy for the actors?
僕はこう映画をちょうどドキュメンタリーで映画を作って、映画学校の卒業制作はアンヌ・キムチという映画なんですけど、ドキュメンタリーで手法として映画を作って10年になるんですね。で、僕はよくドキュメンタリーをジャンルとしてドキュメンタリーっていうふうによく言われるんですけど、僕にとってはこう自分のこう思いを伝える手段というか、伝える映画を作り方がドキュメンタリーとして考えているので、この映画はそのこうやっぱ自分のこうユミカさんに対する気持ちを表現する上でのベストの手段が僕にとってはドキュメンタリーでした。
So I studied a documentary filmmaking and my thesis project from film school was a documentary called Annyeong Kimchi. And so for 10 years my main focus, my main method has been in documentary. But as far as the category of documentary goesFor me, it's still, my films are still a way for me to communicate my thoughts and my feelings. And the method, technique is documentarian, but it's still a way for me, in the case of this film, to express my feelings about Yumika.
So far, the Annyeong Kimchi was a very personal documentary, and if anyone stays for a live tape at 9 o'clock, you'll see that the director's also in that film as well. So could you tell us,the audience probably is not as familiar with Annyeong Kimchi. Would you be able to talk a little bit about that? Because I think it also has some similar subjects to Annyeong Yumika dealing with Korean-Japanese relations.
Annyeong Kimchi というのは、僕は在日三世なんですね。5歳に帰化をしてるんですが、日本国籍に帰化をしてるんですが、僕は韓国人の両親、両親とも韓国人で、で僕は在日コリアンとして、ずっと生まれて育ちました。で家の中に韓国の風習があったんですけど、それに特にこう意識せずにずっと育ってきて、日本の学校 で家族でキムチをいつも作ってたんですけど、僕だけ家族の中でキムチが食べれなかったんですね。はい。
So I myself am actually a third generation ethnically Korean in JapanAt the age of 5, I naturalized as a Japanese citizen, but both my parents are Korean, and I was raised in a Korean household with some Korean customs. And I wasn't, it wasn't a big deal for me, but my family, we did make kimchi, and I was the only person in the family who couldn't eat kimchi.
で、僕はその映画を作るときに、こう家族の中でそれまでこう韓国の話っていうのはしてこなかったんですよ。でもこう映画を作るっていう、こうインタビューをするっていうことを目的にすることで、こう家族の普段話をしないことを一歩踏み込んで話をすることができたんですね。でそのさっきも言ったように、ドキュメンタリーというのはこう現実をそのまま撮るのではなく、僕にとってはこう一歩踏み込むための材料というか、こう人と深く関わるためにドキュメンタリーっていうのをある種作っているような気がします。そういう意味でアンニョンユミカもアンニョンキムチもすごいこう自分のこうパーソナルな部分が映画を作るすごく大きなきっかけになっていると思います。
And before I made that film and my family, we never really talked about Korea, we never discussed our ethnicity, but because I was going to make this film, I was able to actually bring it up as a topic of discussion in the form of interviews with my family. We were actually, because of the film, able to exploreIt's something that we never discussed as a family. And so, as I said before, for me, documentary is a way to not just reflect what reality looks like just by itself, but as an opportunity to explore, get into it, further explore the depths of the topic. And in that sense, both Annyeong Yumika and Annyeong Kimchi are very personal topics, and the trigger that leads me to make the films are very personal. It's a way for me to go into depth more.
で、アンニョンユミカの場合はやはりこうユミカさんの韓国の東京の一妻純子という作品でしたというのが、やはり自分がこうユミカさんについての映画を撮ろうと思った、大きなきっかけでした。で、もともと東京の一妻純子というのは、ユミカさんが亡くなってから本をユミカさんの作品を集めて本を書くという時にたまたま見つかった作品なんです。僕はその本の中で執筆者のうちの一人として関わりました。
So for me, when I wanted to make a film about Yumika, knowing that she had made a Korean film that was set in Tokyo, the Tokyo Housewife Junko, was definitely a point of entry, was definitely something I had interest in. And then after her death, I actually found out about the film after her death when a book was put together about her work. I was one of the editors on the film, as a contributing editor to this film, to this book about her work. That's how I found out about this film that she made.
で、もともとこう映画としてこう安野由美香ができた時に東京の人妻順子のこういろんな背景というのは 見えたんですけど、映画を作る当初はそのコピー、VHS のテープ1本しかなくて資料が何にもなかったんですね。で、何人かこう東京の人妻順子で由美香さんの映画を作ろうと思うっていうふうに何人か話をしたんですが、この映画では何もないから多分調べても難しいと思うよってことを言われたんですけど、僕はちょっとすごくこうこの東京の人妻順子のすごいユーモラスな面が気に入って、きっとこれを作った人たちはやっぱこういい人だと思うし、すごく作った人たちに会いたいっていうのはすごく強く思ったんですね。
As I decided to make this film for Anyo Mimika and I wanted to explore the Tokyo housewife Junko, all I had at that point was just a VHS, one VHS tape of this film and had no background research, no materials surrounding it.And I talked to some people about wanting to make this film about Tokyo Housewife Junko, and they said, there's not going to find anything. It's going to be impossible. You're not going to find anything in your research. But I really love the humor element in Tokyo Housewife Junko, and I believe that the people who had made the film were probably good people. And I really wanted to meet them.
で撮りながらやっぱすごい見つかった部分がすごく多くて、今までドキュメンタリーを作ってきてこんなにこう人から話を聞いて発見があったり、こう自分が本当にコントロールできないようなシナリオが見つかったりとか、すごく撮りながらどんどんどんどん物語が見つかっていったなっていう、印象があります。
And as I was started shooting this documentary, there are so many discoveries and so many surprises along the wayand the story really started to develop on its own out of my own control. And I think that was something very exciting, that it really, there's so many discoveries along the way as I shot this documentary.
What was your first reaction on seeing Junko, the Tokyo Housewives, the film? Hi.
僕はもうとにかくおかしかったですね。で、多分アメリカの方だと、日本語がわかる方だと、東京の人妻順子で語られる日本語のおかしさとか、こう物語の面白さっていうのはちょっとこう日本語分かって語れないとなかなか伝わりにくい部分はあると思うんですが、この映画実は90分あるんですね。で、90分あるうちほとんどこうセックスをしてるんですけど、その、物語がものすごくこうはっちゃめちゃで、僕はとにかく笑いながら見たというのが最初の印象です。
That was hilarious. It was really funny. And there's something I think it's difficult to get if you don't speak Japanese and watching that film. But the Japanese they speak is very awkward. It's funny the way they use Japanese in the film. There's actually 90 minutes of that film, and most of it's sex, and so the story is completely all over the place. But I just remember that I couldn't stop laughing.
Well, thank you for being in the audience. But I have one last question about making the documentary, because you were talking to people who not only have worked with Yumika professionally, but many of them were her ex-lovers. So what were their reactions when you asked them initially to participate in the documentary, when you said you wanted to talk to them about Yumika?
出てくださった方に関しては、僕が直接お願いをして了解をいただきました。で、撮る前にやはりどんな作品にするのかっていうことだったり、そういうことは強く聞かれましたね。
So people you do see appearing in the film, there are people I ask personally myself and ask for their permission and their cooperation. They did really want to know very much about what kind of film I was trying to make and what the project was going to be like.